Hi, I'm Mitchell from 45 Drives with a video where we give you 45 drives in 45 seconds. Today I'm going to be talking about setting up the remote management interface for your Storinator. Storinators use remote management interface called IPMI, which stands for Intelligent Platform Management Interface. This is an open source, industry standard platform that is designed to manage servers remotely across a network. The importance of this is the ability to do such things as control the power of your server, monitor your power supply statistics, as well as troubleshoot and repair the system at a BIOS level, all from a remote location. Next, I'm going to show you just how easy this tool is to set up, which will give you access to your server remotely. Just follow these easy steps. First, plug in an Ethernet cable into an Ethernet port on your motherboard, and the other end into your network switch. In some of our older motherboards, the IPMI port is located here, whereas on the X10 motherboards or higher, it can be plugged into any Ethernet port on the motherboard. Next, access your BIOS by pressing the delete key when the Super Micro splash screen shows up on your monitor. Once in the BIOS, head over to the IPMI tab and scroll down to the BMC network configuration. From here, you can choose DHCP to allow an address to be assigned from your local DHCP server, or set a static IP, which is recommended. Finally, once the IP is assigned, be sure to save the changes and reset your server. Now, it's time to head over to another machine on your network. In an internet browser, type the address assigned to the IPMI port. This will bring up the IPMI login page. The default login credentials are admin, admin, in capital letters. From here, you'll be sent inside the IPMI web GUI and will now have access to a wide range of remote features for your Storinator. One thing to note is you can gain full control of your Storinator from here through a Java application. Just click on the window inside the remote console preview, and this will download a JNLP file, which will open a remote terminal with Java. One final thing of note is that there is also a list of safety features we recommend setting up in order to make your IPMI connection as secure as possible. These features are outlined and much more in our blog post that can be found linked in the description below, as well as a short video that shows the process of setting up the IPMI interface from start to finish. Thanks for watching, and be sure to tune in next Tuesday where we give you another tech tip.